Jai Bharat. Welcome everyone to Advaita Achievers. In this segment, we are going to start with a new chapter, and that is photosynthesis in higher plants. So children, before we begin to discuss the entire process and how it takes place, we need to first have just a brief introduction of what photosynthesis is, right? So photosynthesis is a physicochemical process. हम सब जानते हैं कि photosynthesis important process है, क्योंकि इसी की वजह से green plants जो है वो oxygen release कर रहे हैं and they are making their own food, right? So basically photosynthesis क्या है? Let us check it out that. So photosynthesis is a physicochemical process. Right? जिसकी मदद से green plants use, by which green plants use solar energy and convert it into chemical energy. By which green plants use solar energy and what do? Right? Convert it into chemical energy. Convert it into chemical energy. And is stored in the organic compounds. Correct? So this is basically what photosynthesis is. Now photosynthesis kitna important kyun hai? Why is photosynthesis so very important? It is important for two reasons, right? So, photosynthesis is important for two reasons. Okay? Why? Because it is the primary source of food on earth. Right? We know plants, photosynthesis ki madad se, they prepare their own food, which is consumed by herbivores, in turn reaches to carnivores and omnivores and so on. Correct? So it is the primary source of food on earth. Primary source of food on earth. One thing. Correct? And is responsible for the release of oxygen in the atmosphere. Hawa ko purify karna, in the sense oxygen chhodne ka kaam hawa mein. That is also being done by plants by the process of photosynthesis, right? So another importance of photosynthesis is that it is responsible for release of oxygen in the atmosphere. Release of oxygen in the atmosphere. So for these two reasons, it is a very important process, correct? So if we have to define photosynthesis, right? If I have to define photosynthesis, right? So photosynthesis is defined as a process by which green plants synthesize their own food. Process by which
green plants synthesize their own food.
Correct? Their own food by using water and carbon dioxide.
By using water and carbon dioxide.
Right? In the presence of chlorophyll and sunlight.
In the presence of chlorophyll and sunlight,
right? And what is given out in turn? Oxygen is given out as a byproduct.
Oxygen is given out as a byproduct.
Right? So this is what photosynthesis can be defined as, a process by which green plants synthesize their own food by using water and carbon dioxide in the presence of sunlight and chlorophyll, and oxygen is given out as a byproduct. Right? So this was a brief introduction, and ye sari cheeze aap apni previous classes mein bhi padhe ho. But the next topic that we are going to take up under this is the historical background. Abhi hum jante hain pura process samajh chuke, kyunki scientists ne alag alag experiments karke ye pura process humko samjhaya tha. So we are moving on to the back date. Wahi hum jo kya experiments hue the jiske wajah se hum aaj ka ye pura process samajh pate hain. Correct? We know the entire process. So we are moving on to that portion. Okay? So the historical background. This is what we are going to discuss now. The historical background. Now in this case, one after the other, we will take a look at the work which the different scientists, or the experiments which different scientists have performed, right? So that we will study under the historical background. So first of all, let us take up Van Helmont, right? What he did. So the first one we are considering is Van Helmont. Okay. What he showed? He showed that soil did not add to the mass of a growing plant. The soil did not add any mass to a growing plant. I'll be explaining this. Showed that soil did not add, right, mass to a growing plant. Now what does this mean? What he actually did was, he took up, he performed an experiment using a potted plant. What he did, he first weighed the plant. Usne pehle jo plant usne chota sa liya tha, uska wazan measure kiya. So he measured the weight of the plant. And then separately he also measured the weight of the soil. Jitna soil use karke usko us plant mein pot kiya gaya tha, theek hai, usko yahan pe lagaya gaya tha. Then he allowed it to grow for a certain period of time. Chalte raha. After some time, some maane socho saal ek saal ke baad. Theek hai. Then again he tried to weigh both the things separately. Plant ka bhi aur jo soil usme dala gaya tha, uska bhi unhone alag se wazan kiya. What he noticed, ek saal ke baad ya do saal ke baad, whatever, after some period of time, aise samajhna hai hume. उन्होंने क्या देखा, क्योंकि प्लांट में ग्रोथ प्रोसेस हुआ था तो प्लांट का जो वेट था वो बढ़ गया था फ्रॉम इट्स इनिशियल वेट. करेक्ट? और जो सॉइल था उसका भी उन्होंने वजन किया, तो उसका वजन जो था वो इतना कुछ कम नहीं हुआ था. अगर प्लांट के ग्रोथ प्रोसेस में सॉइल मदद कर रही होती, मास उसको सॉइल ऐड करा रहा होता, तो सॉइल का मास कम हो जाना चाहिए था, वेट कम हो जाना चाहिए था, ठीक है? जबकि ऐसा नहीं हुआ. एक एग्जांपल लेते हैं, जस्ट इट्स अ जस्ट सिंपल थिंग टू अंडरस्टैंड, ठीक है? सपोज वी आर टेकिंग दैट द सॉइल ही यूज्ड इनिशियली वॉज वेइंग से 100 ग्राम, ठीक है? एंड द प्लांट ही यूज्ड, सपोज एक जनरल एग्जांपल लेते हैं, उसका वजन हुआ था सपोज से 10 ग्राम्स, ठीक है? आफ्टर दैट ग्रोथ पीरियड व्हेन अगेन ही वेड, व्हाट ही नोटिस्ड दैट द प्लांट वॉज वेइंग सम से 1000 ग्राम, दैट इज अ केजी और समथिंग, ओके? पर सॉइल का जो वजन था वो उसका मास तो सिर्फ 99 ही हुआ था, ठीक है? तो व्हाट डज दिस शो कि प्लांट के मास में एडिशन अगर सॉइल कर रहा होता तो यहाँ पे उसके मास में काफी कम होना चाहिए था, पर वैसा कुछ हुआ नहीं. अंडरस्टूड? सो ऑन बेस ऑफ दिस एक्सपेरिमेंट ही शो दैट सॉइल डिड नॉट एड मास टू द ग्रोइंग प्लांट. दिस वॉज वन थिंग. Okay, let us move to the second example. Okay, the second work shown by scientists, and that is Priestley. Okay, so children, presently we know the entire process of photosynthesis, but there has been many experiments performed by various scientists which now give us a clear idea, and now so we are very clear ki entire process kaise hota hai. So we are now going to take a look at the historical background, right? So one by one we'll be trying to understand the various experiments that are performed by different scientists. So the first we take up is Van Helmont. They have contributed, right, to understand the process, right? So one by one we'll be taking. So first one we take is Van Helmont. What did he show, right? He showed that soil did not add mass to a growing plant. Showed that soil did not add mass to a growing plant, right? Now what does this mean? What did he try to show by his experiment? ठीक है, तो उन्होंने क्या किया था, उन्होंने एक प्लांट लिया, उसको अलग से वे किया, मेजर किया उसका वजन, ठीक है? एंड अलग से सॉइल जो उसमें वो डालने वाले थे उसको भी उन्होंने मेजर किया, ठीक? फॉर एग्जाम्पल मैं एक फिगर ले रही हूँ, ठीक है? सो सपोज द सॉइल ही टुक वॉज से सम 100 ग्राम, और उस टाइम पे बिफोर द ग्रोथ ऑफ द प्लांट, उस प्लांट का वजन से एक एग्जाम्पल ले लेते होगा शायद से 10 ग्राम, ठीक है? फिर देन वॉट ही डिड, उन्होंने उस प्लांट को इस सॉइल में पॉट कर दिया, लगा दिया उस पौधे को, ठीक है? एंड ही जस्ट केप्ट वॉटरिंग, पानी डालते रहे. आफ्टर सम टाइम, थोड़े टाइम के बाद उन्होंने वापस से अलग से दोनों को मेजर किया, ठीक? तो जो प्लांट उन्होंने मेजर किया तो उस प्लांट का वेट काफी बढ़ा था, क्योंकि प्लांट के अंदर क्या हुआ था, वॉट हैड हैपेंड, ग्रोथ हैड टेकन प्लेस, राइट? सो दिस प्लांट वॉज वेइंग से सम 1000 ग्राम्स, देयर वॉज मच मोर ग्रोथ, सो क्वाइट अ more mass the plant had gained. Whereas soil का जब वजन किया गया वापस तो उसमें एक negligible reduction देखने मिला, say 99 grams, ठीक? तो जो वो सोच रहे थे कि अगर soil में से कुछ ऐसा हो रहा है कि जो plant को growth में help कर रहा है तो plant का वजन बढ़ेगा, वो सही है, पर सामने soil का भी comparatively ज़्यादा कम होना चाहिए था, पर ऐसा नहीं हुआ, it did not take place. So he proved that soil did not add mass to a growing plan. So this was the first experiment we understood, given by Van Helmont. Let us take up the second one, which was explained by Priestley. What did he had to say? We'll first write the statement and then we will come back to understand it. Okay? Plants restore to the air whatever breathing animals and burning candle removes Now what does this mean? Right? See, उन्होंने एक एक्सपेरिमेंट किया जिसको बेल जार एक्सपेरिमेंट बोलते हैं. What he did? He took a burning candle and a potted plant and covered it with a bell jar. Right? और उनको ऑब्जर्व करते रहे. थोड़े टाइम बाद the candle kept burning and the plant was healthy enough. But when he placed, फिर दूसरे टाइम पर उन्होंने क्या किया, कैंडल को एक अलग बेल, बर्निंग कैंडल को अलग बेल जार में रखा और उस पॉटेड प्लांट को भी अलग बेल जार में रखा. तो थोड़े टाइम में क्या हुआ, कैंडल जो थी वो बुझ गई, इट गॉट एक्सटिंग्विश्ड, करेक्ट. एंड द प्लांट ऑल्सो आफ्टर सम टाइम इट स्टार्टेड टू विल्ट, मतलब वो मुरझाना शुरू हो गया था. तो उन्होंने उसमें से क्या अंदाजा निकाला कि प्लांट्स क्या करते हैं, प्लांट्स रिस्टोर टू द एयर, वापस देते हैं क्या, whatever breathing animals and burning candle removes. अभी के टाइम पे हम जानते हैं that we are taking in oxygen and giving out carbon dioxide. और candle को burn करने के लिए भी, combustion की process के लिए भी oxygen का जरूर होना जरूरी है, correct? वो हम अब जानते हैं. इसलिए उन्होंने ऐसा बोला, तब these things were not clear. तो तब उन्होंने ऐसा बोला था कि plants restore करते हैं, वापस air को देते हैं, क्या चीज़ है, जो बर्निंग कैंडल और ब्रीदिंग एनिमल्स हवा में से रिमूव करते हैं. हम रिमूव क्या करते हैं, हम ऑक्सीजन ले लेते हैं ना, तो हम हवा में से वो ले रहे हैं और कार्बन डाइऑक्साइड छोड़ रहे हैं, ठीक है. पर यहाँ पे उन्होंने ये क्लियर ऐसा दिखाया, इट वाज नॉट मेंट क्लियर दैट टाइम. यू अंडरस्टूड दिस वेरी क्लियर, राइट? सो ही शोड दैट प्लांट्स टेक कार्बन डाइऑक्साइड फ्रॉम द एटमोसफियर एंड रिलीजेस ऑक्सीजन, विच इज नाउ वेरी क्लियर. Clear? And even he then, in place of this candle and this plant also, he used a mice also, and the same experiment was performed. Clear? So this was done by Priestley. Moving on to the next one, that was Jan Ingenhouse. So what did he show? What did he do? He showed that sunlight is essential for photosynthesis. How? Showed that sunlight is essential for photosynthesis. कैसे, what did he do? Now he performed experiment on aquatic plants, ठीक है, पानी में रहने वाले plants, aquatic plants, और उनको he observed किया day time पे. So what he observed during day time, that there were bubbles which were coming out of them. अगर aquatic plants को पानी में छोड़ो day time पे तो क्या होता है, अभी हम जानते हैं कि photosynthesis की process होगी तो वो carbon dioxide कंज्यूम करेंगे और ऑक्सीजन रिलीज करेंगे, पर उस टाइम पे वो पता नहीं था कि वो जो बबल्स निकल रहे हैं वो ऑक्सीजन के. लेटर ऑन इट वाज डिस्कवर्ड कि दैट गैस वाज ऑक्सीजन, करेक्ट. सो व्हाट ही ऑब्जर्व, द एक्सपेरिमेंट वाज डन ऑन
the experiment was done on aquatic plants. Okay, so aquatic plants were kept under in the sunlight, in water during daytime. Aquatic plants in water during daytime. Right? During daytime, there were the giving of bubbles. Which we now know that those bubbles are of oxygen. Correct? So this was the experiment performed by Ingenhouse. And he said that sunlight is essential for photosynthesis. Another experiment was performed by Sachs. It was performed by Sachs. And what did he say? Right? He said plants produce glucose during photosynthesis. Plants produce glucose during photosynthesis. Right? This was given by Sachs. Another important experiment was carried out by Engelmann. Let us see that now. We are done with the four experiments or the work contributed by four scientists. We are moving on to the fifth one, and that is Engelmann. Okay, what he did? He used a green alga, Cladophora. Remember the name of the alga, okay? Green alga, Cladophora. Alright. And what did he do with this Cladophora? It was kept in a watery aquatic medium, and he allowed to refract the visible light. We know कि visible light में वो सात colors होते हैं, vibrio होते हैं, correct? तो setup कुछ इस तरीके का था, say एक ऐसा aquatic medium था, right? It was filled with water like this, and with the help of the prism, the visible light was allowed to fall in this cladophora. Cladophora इसके अंदर है, जो green color की alga है. फिर क्या हुआ? What did he notice? Right? He showed that maximum absorption कहाँ हुआ? वो दिखाया उन्होंने. पर कैसे? चलो एक कोशिश करते हैं. हम इधर vibgyor लिखते हैं. ठीक है? V I B G Y O R. Why I am writing this? It has an importance. समझने की कोशिश कर. तो उन्होंने ये ऑब्जर्व किया कि जो क्लैडोफोरा जो कि ग्रीन अल्गा है, I don't know whether this will be visible to you or not. जो ग्रीन अल्गा है वो ज़्यादातर कहाँ इकट्ठा हुई, right? He was able to see that cladophora accumulated in the red and the blue region. तो blue region यहाँ पे है, so it accumulated here in the blue and the red region more. आया समझ में? तो इसकी मदद से what did he conclude? Right? That he said that maximum absorption light का, ये vibrio क्या है? Visible light, correct? So maximum absorption of light takes place in red and blue light. So what did he notice? Maximum, right? Maximum absorption takes place where? In the red and blue light. In the red and blue light. Right? This is clear? So this was the experiment performed by Engelmann using Cladophora. Alright? Another example we are taking, or the next experiment, that is by Blackman. What did he show? showed that capturing photosynthetic energy requires sunlight. उस photosynthetic energy को, जिस energy से photosynthesis का process होगा, उसको capture करने के लिए sunlight की जरूरत है. While building organic molecules does not. मैं समझाती हूँ, पहले हम ये लिख लेते हैं. What did he explain? Capturing photosynthetic energy. Capturing photosynthetic energy requires sunlight. Correct? Why? Building organic molecules does not. इसके मायने क्या होते हैं, चलो समझो इधर. Pay attention everyone. Capturing photosynthetic energy माने sunlight को capture करना, photosynthesis करने के लिए sunlight की जरूरत है, और organic molecules बनाने के लिए नहीं. See, now we have an idea कि the process of photosynthesis जो है उसको हम दो हिस्सों में बांट देते हैं, लाइट रिएक्शन एंड डार्क रिएक्शन, है ना. तो लाइट रिएक्शन में हम जानते हैं कि लाइट रिएक्शन का होना, होने के लिए फोटोसिंथेसिस का जो फर्स्ट फेज है उसके होने के लिए सनलाइट की जरूरत है, इसीलिए हम उसको लाइट रिएक्शन बोल रहे हैं, करेक्ट. पर जो डार्क रिएक्शन है जिसमें हम अल्टीमेटली द कार्बोहाइड्रेट इज गोइंग टू बी सिंथेसाइज्ड, है ना, तो वो ऑर्गेनिक मॉलिक्यूल बन रहा है, उसमें हम सनलाइट को यूज नहीं कर रहे हैं. And hence we are calling it dark reaction. ऐसा नहीं है कि वो अंधेरे में हो रहा है इसलिए dark reaction है. It is a light independent reaction. इसलिए उसको हम बोल रहे हैं dark reaction, right? So that was shown by Blackman that capturing photosynthetic energy, जो light reaction के लिए energy चाहिए, sunlight trap करने के लिए, sunlight की उसमें ज़रूरत है, ताकि that energy will get converted, है ना, photolysis of water होगा, ठीक है, वो वाटर मॉलिक्यूल को ब्रेक करना विद द हेल्प ऑफ सनलाइट. तो इस वजह से उस वो एनर्जी हमें चाहिए, क्योंकि हमें एक रिडक्शन पावर क्रिएट करना है, राइट. तो वो पावर क्रिएट करने के लिए हमें, वो एनर्जी क्रिएट करने के लिए हमें सनलाइट की ज़रूरत है. पर उसके बाद वाला जो स्टेप है, जो कि डार्क रिएक्शन है जिसमें वो ऑर्गेनिक मॉलिक्यूल बनता है, दैट डज नॉट रिक्वायर सनलाइट. क्लियर? सो दैट वॉज, दिस वॉज गिवन बाय Blackman, right? I hope everyone is clear till here. Moving on to next. So the next one was, we are moving to seventh, right? The seventh one. That is Van Niel. So what does Mr. Van Niel do? So Van Niel, he worked on purple and green bacteria, okay? Worked on purple and green bacteria, alright, and demonstrated that photosynthesis is a light dependent reaction, and showed, remember, and showed, photosynthesis is a light dependent reaction. Clear? In which hydrogen from oxidizable, suitable oxidizable compound reduces carbon dioxide to carbohydrates. Let us complete writing, then I'm coming to it. So, in which hydrogen from a suitable oxidizable compound hydrogen from a suitable oxidizable compound reduces carbon dioxide to carbohydrates. What does this mean? We know that the entire process of photosynthesis is divided into two parts, light reaction, dark reaction, correct? The light reaction mein jo pehla step hum kar rahe hain, that was this photolysis of water. So, hydrogen, ye hydrogen hai, wo hume kahan se mil raha hai? It comes from a suitable oxidizable compound. And this suitable oxidizable compound is nothing but is water. Water splits into H plus and OH minus, correct? So that way it is splitting. And this is used to create a suitable reducing power. हम आगे प्रोसेस में पढ़ेंगे वो रिड्यूसिंग पावर क्या है. ठीक है, तो रिड्यूसिंग पावर बनाने में इसकी मदद होती है. और ये हमें कहाँ से मिलता है? फ्रॉम अ सूटेबल ऑक्सीडाइजेबल कंपाउंड, एंड दैट सूटेबल ऑक्सीडाइजेबल कंपाउंड इज वाटर. तो फोटोलिसिस ऑफ वाटर होता है. ठीक है, एंड देन दिस हाइड्रोजन विच इज फॉर्म्ड इज यूज्ड टू क्रिएट अ रिड्यूसिंग पावर. और वो रिड्यूसिंग पावर की मदद से क्या बनता है? कार्बन डाइऑक्साइड को रिड्यूस करके कार्बोहाइड्रेट बनता है. करेक्ट, सो दिस वॉज गिवन बाय वैन नील. अनदर एक्सपेरिमेंट वॉज परफॉर्म्ड बाय रॉबर्ट हिल. राइट, इट वॉज डन बाय रॉबर्ट हिल एंड ही शोड दैट प्लांट्स कुड यूज लाइट एनर्जी to generate reducing power. Plants could use light energy to generate reducing power It is, of course, in support of this only. No, it said that oxidizable compound में से hydrogen मिलता है जो reduction power बनाएगा. तो plants use light energy, photolysis of water, breaking down of water molecule with the help of light. Right? So that is that thing which is there. Is this clear to everyone? All right? So till Robert Hill we are clear. We have a few more to discuss. All right? So let's move on to the next one. The next one that we are taking is Theodore. What did he show? He showed that water is an essential requirement for photosynthesis to occur. Water is an essential requirement for photosynthesis to occur. Photosynthesis होने के लिए वॉटर जरूरी है. दैट इज ऑल्सो इन सपोर्ट टू द एक्सपेरिमेंट परफॉर्म बाय वैन नील एंड रॉबर्ट हिल. ओके, आफ्टर दैट कम्स एमर्सन. एमर्सन शोड दैट देर आर टू फोटो सिस्टम्स इन प्लांट्स. There are two photosystems in plants. We call it to be PS1 photosystem 1 and photosystem 2, right? Children, we are going to discuss both of these into detail, right? So there are these two photosystems in plants, and he explained the emergence effect. Emergence effect, or it is also called red drop. This also we are going to understand in details. So that time I'll come back to this. And he explained that this process takes place in two forms, that is light reaction and dark reaction. It has two steps, light reaction and dark reaction, right? And finally, the last that we are going to discuss over here, right, that is Melvin Kelvin, right? And his contribution, right, is very, very important because he explained or gave the C3 cycle. We call C3 cycle, or we call it to be Kelvin cycle, or we know this process by dark reaction, right? So this also we are going to discuss in detail. So with this, we are done discussing the historical background of photosynthesis, the contribution of various scientists in the process, understanding of the process, right? Children, when you will read the different reference books, you will see that there are many other scientists who have contributed, and their contributions are given over there. But what I have taken here right now are the ones which are the most important ones, right? So when you go through the reference book, you may see many other different scientists as well. I hope you have followed. Thank you, and Jai Bharat.